In the last lecture, we completed NOT gate. In this lecture, we will complete AND gate. There are 6 points that we have to discuss. First one is symbol. Second one is truth table. Then we have associative law, commutative law, enable and disable. And the last one is unused input. I will explain all the 6 points one by one. And we will start with AND operator. In AND operator, output is high when all the inputs are high. So in AND operator, if you want your output to be 1, you have to make all your inputs equal to 1. And we implement AND operator by using electronic device, and this electronic device we call as AND gate. So AND gate is an electronic device which is used to implement AND operator. First thing in AND gate is symbol. I will make 2 input AND gate. This is how we represent AND gate. We have 2 inputs A and B. This is how we represent output Y, and Y is equal to A and B. This dot here is AND operator. This is not multiplication, so don't confuse yourself. Now we will make 3 input AND gate. Let's say the 3 inputs are X, Y and Z, and the output is equal to F. So F is equal to X and Y and Z. So this is the symbol for AND gate. Now we will move to truth table. I will take 2 input AND gate. So we have A and B, 2 inputs, and output is Y. As there are 2 inputs, we will have 4 possible combinations: 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. These are the 4 combinations, and we have to find out Y depending upon the values of A and B. And as you already know, in case of AND operator, output is high when all the inputs are high. So output Y for first case is equal to 0 because both A and B are 0. In second case also, output is equal to 0 because A is 0. In third case, output is 0 because B is 0. And in last case, output is equal to 1 because both A and B are high. So this is the truth table for AND gate, and this truth table is very important because we will use this a lot in this course. Now we will move to third point, that is associative law. We have to find whether AND gate follows the associative law or not. Associative law says A and B and C equals to A and B and C. On left hand side, we will perform AND operation for B and C first, and let's say the result is X. Then we will perform AND operation for A and X. On the right hand side, we will perform AND operation for A and B. This will give us Y, let's say. And then we'll perform AND operation for C and Y. And if we get equal results, we can say that AND gate follows the associative law. So let's try to prove this. We will prove this by the help of one example. Let's say A is equal to 1, B is equal to 0, and C is equal to 1. First, we will solve for left hand side A and B and C. A is equal to 1, B is equal to 0, and C is equal to 1. 0 and 1 is 0, so we have 1 and 0, and this will give us 0. Now we will solve for right hand side is A and B and C. A is equal to 1, A is equal to 1, B is equal to 0, and C is equal to 1. 1 and 0 is 0, 0 and 1 is 0. So we got the same results for left hand side and right hand side, and we can say that AND gate follows the associative law. Now we'll move to fourth point, that is commutative law. Commutative law says A and B equals to B and A. And we have to find whether AND gate follows the commutative law or not. I will take one example. A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0. First we will evaluate the left hand side A and B. A is 1, B is 0. So we'll get 0. Then we will find out the right hand side. B is 0, A is 1, this will make no difference. We will get result as 0. So left hand side and right hand side are same. So we can say that AND gate follows the commutative law. So AND gate follows both associative and commutative law. We are done with 4 points: symbol, truth table, associative and commutative law. Now the important part comes. We have to discuss enable and disable. This is little bit tricky, but it is very interesting. We will make the truth table first. For two input AND gate, A, B are the two inputs, and Y is the output. 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. These are the four combinations, and output is 0 0 0 1. Now we have to find out enable and disable for AND gate. We will use this truth table to find enable and disable for AND gate. But first I will explain meaning of enable and disable for a logic gate. Let's say this is any logic gate with two inputs A and B. This is A, this is B, and the output is Y. Now let us consider a situation in which B is equal to 0. B is equal to 0, and when B is 0, the output is fixed. The output is fixed, and let's say it is equal to 1. So we can say that this logic gate here is disabled because there is no effect of A. The output is always equal to 1 because B is equal to 0. If we make A equals to 1, then also output is equal to 0, and if we make A equals to 0, then also output is equal to 0. So this gate is disabled, and we will say 0 is disabled for this logic gate. Similarly, we will find out enable, and enable will make this gate functional. It will not disable the gate. For example, let's say when B is equal to 1, the output Y is equal to A, or other case is A complement. So this gate is not disabled, but this gate is enabled, because B is not fixing the output. If A is 0, and let us consider output is equal to A, we will not consider this case. When A is equal to 0, the output is going to be 0. When A is equal to 1, the output is going to be 1. So the output Y is not fixed. It depends on A, and it is acting as buffer. You can say it is acting as buffer because Y is equal to A. And we will say that this one here is enable for this logic gate. So enable and disable is nothing but 0 and 1. We have to find enable, whether it is 0 or 1. And in the same way, we have to find disable, whether it is 0 or 1. And how we can do this? We can do this easily by using the truth table for the logic gate. Like in this case, this is the truth table for AND gate, and we will find out disable and enable for AND gate. So we will first find out disable. I will consider the first two cases in which A is equal to 0, and when A is equal to 0, the output is equal to 0. There is no effect of B. B is 0, then also output is equal to 0. B is 1, then also output is equal to 0. So we can say that 0 is disable for the AND gate, and output is equal to 0. Now we will consider the last two cases when A is equal to 1. When A is equal to 1, output is equal to 0 and 1. When B is 0 and when B is equal to 1. So 1 is acting as enable with buffer. Why it is buffer? Because Y is equal to B. So I will write this down. 0 is disable for AND gate with output equals to 0. If I make two input AND gate, this is two input AND gate, and let's say we have a 0 as the second input, and this is A, the first input, then the output Y is equal to 0, because 0 is disabled. When A is 0, output is equal to 0. When A is 1, output is equal to 1. So there is no effect of A, and 0 is acting as disable for the AND gate. 1 is enable for AND gate. one is enable for AND gate, and it is acting as buffer. If I make two input AND gate and second input is equal to 1, first input is equal to A, then output Y is equal to A. From this truth table we can see output Y is equal to B when we made input A equals to 1. So when A is 0, output is going to be 0. When A is 1, output is going to be 1. So this is how we find enable and disable. Now we will move to next point, that is unused input. Before moving to unused inputs, let's see two important points. The first point is in TTL logic, transistor logic, if any input is open or floating, it will act as one. And in case of ECL logic, if any input is open or floating, it will act as zero. So this is very important point, and in your competitive exam mostly problems will come on this concept, that in TTL logic, if any input is open or floating, it will act as 1, and in ECL logic, if any input is open or floating, it will act as 0. Now we can discuss unused input. There are three ways to deal with unused input. In first way, we can connect the unused input to logic 1. If this is the AND gate with three inputs A, B, and this third input is open or floating, the output is Y, then we can connect this unused input to 1, or we can simply connect this to VCC, where VCC is the high voltage. These are A and B with output equal to Y. So this is the first way to deal with unused input. We can connect the unused input, the floating input, to logic 1. The second way is to connect it with one of the used inputs. For example, let's take two input AND gate. The first input is A and the second input is floating. So we can connect it with one of the used input, that is A. So Y is equal to A and A, or it is equal to A. So these are the two ways. Now we will move to third way to deal with unused input, and we will use this concept that in TTL logic, if any input is open or floating, it will act as 1, and in ECL logic, it will act as 0. In case of AND gate, we want open or floating input act as 1, because 1 is enable for AND gate. So what we can do, if there is TTL logic, then the open input will act as 1. In TTL logic, the open input, this is A and this is open input, then this will act as 1 and output is equal to A and 1. And this is not applicable for ECL logic, because in case of ECL logic, the open or floating input will act as 0. And if it will act as 0, the output is going to be 0. The AND gate will be disabled. So we don't want this. So these are the three ways to deal with unused inputs. Now we will move to homework problem. I have two homework problems for you. In first homework problem, you have to find the output Y. In second homework problem, you have to find the output F. Once you have your answers, post them in comment section. This is all for this lecture. See you in the next one.